Yeah, that's true. We are only human. We can't regenerate fingers the way a gecko regrows its tail. But it is possible to reattach severed digits. Didn't you see that episode of Grey's Anatomy? No, seriously. We can reattach fingers and we can take all sorts of human tissue from one area of the body and implant it into another. So let's get into it. The Demystifying Medicine channel introduces you to the super cool but super complex world of microsurgery. So what exactly is microsurgery? Intuitively, microsurgery means tiny surgery, but what exactly is tiny? And how does it turn us into geckos? Well, the core component of microsurgery can be summed up with two very intimidating words, microvascular anastomosis. Let's break it down. The word anastomosis refers to the surgical procedure where two body structures are connected. A microvascular anastomosis refers to two blood vessels being connected. In this case, I'm talking about arteries and veins. Arteries and veins are very small and very intricate, hence the term microsurgery. Arteries carry blood away from the heart, and veins carry blood towards the heart. Bottom line, they carry blood and they supply tissues with the oxygen, nutrients, and other vital molecules that are in the blood. And so, if we're going to implant tissue or reattach fingers, we need to reattach, or anastomose, all the proper arteries and veins so that the previously detached tissue can now receive blood, oxygen, nutrients, all that good stuff, and therefore stay alive and viable. If we cannot anastomose the blood vessels, there is no hope. The replanted tissue will die. There are certainly other components to this procedure. The microsurgeon would also reattach nerves to preserve sensation and, of course, physically attach digits or tissues with sutures. But the microvascular anastomosis is key. It is usually what dictates whether the procedure succeeds or fails. Okay, let's recap what we just learned. Microsurgery is essentially taking tissue from one part of the body and implanting it somewhere else, or taking an amputated body part and replanting it. The donor site, aka the amputated digit or tissue that is being implanted somewhere, is studied under a microscope and its major blood vessels are isolated. Then, the recipient site, aka where that donor tissue is going, is studied under a microscope and its major blood vessels are isolated. Then, the donor arteries and veins are anastomosed to the recipient arteries and veins. To visualize this procedure, I find it helps to picture the ends of two tunnels that are approximately the same size. The tunnel ends are lined up together, and then someone comes and pours concrete around the slit, sealing the two tunnel ends together and forming one big tunnel. Except the tunnels are blood vessels and the concrete is sutures. After the anastomoses, the surgeons will close up the incision sites, setting the implanted tissue into its new home and send the patient off to recovery. Okay. Now that we understand the basics, let's talk about two broad categories of microsurgery. First, we have replantation procedures, and it is exactly what it sounds like, surgically replanting or reattaching amputated body parts, like fingers and toes. Diagnostic indications for this surgery are fairly obvious. No one needs this surgery unless they've undergone some kind of physical trauma that results in a complete or partial amputation. Second, we have free flap procedures. Free flap surgery is where a surgeon takes a flap of tissue, which can be bone, muscle, and skin, and implants that tissue into another area of the body. This surgery is typically done to restore some form and function that was impaired by cancer or other physical trauma. For example, patients with sarcoma, which is bone cancer, must often undergo extensive tumor resections, which means that cancerous and often healthy bone must be removed. Suppose a patient with a tumor in their right femur must undergo a resection. After the surgeon is done, the patient is left with a large bony defect, which means they have a lack of bone. A microsurgeon can come in and harvest a free flap, some bone and skin from, let's say, the left fibula, and use this to reconstruct the femoral defect. The peroneal artery, which serves the fibula flap, is connected to the femoral artery, and the peroneal vein is connected to the femoral vein. This helps preserve the patient's ability to walk. Now you might be thinking to yourself, okay, so we fixed the femoral defect in the right leg, but what about the left leg? Can we really just take a segment of bone from the left fibula without compromising the patient's ability to walk on that left leg? Well, the answer is yes. Fibula flaps can be harvested without comprising the fibula or the major nerves around it, and the bone can regenerate within 6 months to 2.5 years. Now that we've talked about the microsurgical categories, let's talk about the primary reason for replant and free flap failure, thrombosis, which is a fancy term for blood clots. There are many reasons thrombosis occurs. One example is kinking, where the anastomosed blood vessels can form sharp angles, hindering blood flow and producing clots. If the free flap or replanted tissue cannot receive adequate blood flow, it will die. Most free flaps and replants fail within 48 hours post-op, but sometimes the flap or replant can be salvaged if the surgeon intervenes quickly enough. Not all reoperations are successful, however. Sometimes blood clots form or blood flow is inadequate despite multiple different interventions. For example, after evacuating a blood clot and re-anastomosing the vessels, the surgeon might start the patients on anticoagulants, which are blood clot inhibitors. This might work or it might not, and it is unclear why, which is part of what makes microsurgery so interesting. It is such a fascinating and important surgery, but it is fairly new and incredibly complex. We're still learning so much about it. Thank you for watching. Make sure to like this video and check out the other videos on the Demystifying Medicine channel.